boy, Brother Kwame from the Lion of Judah teaching. I'm back at it with another video. And in this video, I'm going to be responding to the brother Kevin Wesley, the ex-pastor. The brother Kevin Wesley has sent me innumerable messages in my email challenging me to a dialogue, a live, and I guess he's trying to convince me to turn over to his belief. Okay, question to you, brother Kevin Wesley. How you gonna convince me to come over to your belief when you don't even understand anything about the ancient writings of the Metaneter? You disrespected me because you wasted my time talking about you wanna go live with me, talking about how brilliant I am in the mind and stuff, but you declined to have the sit down dialogue live with me tonight. You disrespected everyone's time. I had everybody hitting me up saying, when, what time is it, what time is it? The reason why I didn't give you all the time, because I was waiting on the brother Kevin Wesley. The brother Kevin Wesley, he said he didn't want to do it. He didn't want to have a live with me. So now what brother Kwame is about to do, I'm about to deal with you, Kevin Wesley. See, this is what a lot of people don't understand and know about you. You don't go live with anybody. You like to sit there and type thousands of words on the internet, and you might make a video here and there, but you never sit down and have a dialogue. You challenge me, you call brother Kwame out. Now you decline to have a live with me, and you're gonna run around here and tell everybody, oh, brother Kwame, he's upset because he just wants some attention, he just wants some fame, he just wanna be glorified. It don't have anything to do with that. It's a lot of people that has questions. It's a lot of people that wants answers, because you confused everybody when you went viral somehow with this, oh, I'm an ex-pastor sitting up in your car with your cowboy hat on talking about something. You were ex-pastor. You knew you was about to get towed up. You knew that. You just wanted some attention. Brother Kwame didn't want any attention. Brother Kwame is here for his brothers and sisters for real. I like to uplift everyone. I like for everybody to be edified. I like for everybody to actually learn something. So I felt like, okay, Brother Wesley, you don't want to challenge me. You called me up. I didn't challenge you, as you can see on the screen. Brother Kwame never once challenged you. You came at me, talking about you been watching my videos, you and your wives. You and your wives been watching Brother Kwame's videos. So you decided to challenge me and go live with me, which I was surprised, because it seems like everybody has been trying to get in contact with you and trying to go live with you ever since back in 2017 when you dropped that video that went viral talking about, oh, I'm an ex-pastor, I'm here, I'm this, I'm this, and I'm that. Oh, the Bible was written by a white man to keep us in slavery. Show it, prove it. You're gonna have to give me some scripture. And this don't have anything to do with no race thing right now, people. But the brother Kevin Wesley must be edified right now. The brother said that the Bible was written by a white man to keep us black people in slavery. If that is true, why in the world did the so-called white man leave all of the images of the prophets in the Bible, including Jesus Christ, black? They all were Negro people. Why did he leave them black? But he painted their pictures to the world and showing the world that they are white. Come on now, you have a white Jesus right now. A white Jesus with long hair. You have, he got blue eyes, but the Bible clearly tells you that Jesus had white woolly hair. It tells you that Jesus was a Negro man. It tells you that Jesus sprang from the tribe of Judah. He sprang out of Judah according to Hebrews 7:14. Judah were a Negro people. So why in the world would he leave Christ's heritage inside of the Bible black? Him, Christ, being black, but he come out here in the world and paint an image of a white Moses, paint an image of a white King David, paint an image of a white Jesus, when the Bible clearly substantiates that all of these people were Negro people, that were black descended people. And I know a lot of you all black people that has been brainwashed through the history of this world, so y'all gonna come out and try to say, oh, it doesn't matter what color he is, all you gotta do is just believe. It does matter, because it's in the Bible. It's in the Bible, so stop that foolery. But back to you, Kevin Wesley. You need to understand that you can't deal with Brother Kwame any kind of type of way. I'm not your ordinary preacher or Christian-based person. Like I told those other cats that was trying to get at me over the years, they would go and make a video about me, but they would never ever sit down, take the time out to just sit down and go live with me and discuss our issues, our biblical issues, our historical issues, whatever kind of issues that we had with one another. They would never take that time out to just sit down and go live with the brother Kwame. Instead, they want to go and make a video about me, or you got some people that would like to just sit there and post 700 to 900 something words and want to type and try to argue over the post. That way y'all can try to run to the internet and try to run to Google and try to ask them for help to try to save y'all. But like I said, I'm not trying to pick at y'all for doing stuff like that. Me, Brother Kwame, I'm confident in what I believe in. I'm confident in the doctrine that I teach. Not to try to say that I know every single thing on the planet Earth, but I'm confident in my belief. I'm confident in it. So if you're that confident in your teachings, you don't have to try to run to Google for help. You can sit there and have a live dialogue with me in front of your people. You can sit there and have a conversation with me over the phone, or however you want to do it. Don't try to run from the dialogue with me. You don't want to call me out. You don't want, I got the proof right here in my emails. You reached out to Brother Kwame. To be honest, I forgot all about you. Ever since that stunt that you tried to pull back in 2017, the video that you went viral off of, now I'm starting to believe that you did it for attention, just based off the email that you just sent me recently. You did that for fame, because you understand that the way this world is going right now, in the position that it's going, a lot of people are starting to turn away from the Bible. So you use that as, okay, now, oh, I'm an ex-pastor. I don't believe in the Bible anymore. For one, you don't know enough to go live with me, not to try to knock you down or anything, but I'm being 100% honest. I'm not trying to glorify Brother Kwame myself. I am glorifying the Most High God, Yahweh. That's all I glorify. That's all I've been glorifying ever since I've been here on YouTube or Facebook, whatever platform that I'm on teaching. Now, I'm not like my man, Almond Coleman. Almond Coleman is somebody who will make a thread, a post on Facebook. And Almond, he's a young apologist. He blogged. He's going to go in. He's going to do that. That's what he do. He's gonna go in and write 500-750 something words, 9-10 paragraphs. I don't do that. Brother Kwame don't do that. I told Kevin, let's talk about this. Let's deal with this. Let's have a conversation about it. Whether you wanna go live, whether you wanna have a phone conversation with the Brother Kwame, it doesn't matter to me. But it goes, Kevin, oh, you just gonna come from the book? They scared of the Bible. Everybody that's scared to have a live with me, they're scared of the Bible. Even people that believes in the Bible, they run away from the Bible. Whenever I bring out a scripture, they run away from it. I'm telling you, these people are afraid of the Most High God. We can bring out them history books. We can bring out the scholastical sources and all of that stuff. But what you must realize, Brother Kevin Wesley, those books, the scholastical sources, all of that stuff were man ideas. It came from the thoughts of man. Oh, man wrote the Bible. Oh, yeah, man also wrote history as well, too. That's why it's called history. His story. These people, quote unquote, so-called supposed to be conscious, they feel that, oh, yeah, because you're a Christian or you're a Bible believer, whatever you believe in, it's just a belief system. Your master teacher came and made a video about me talking about some, oh, it's a belief system. Memphidisha, he the one that probably told you to cancel the dialogue that me and you were supposed to have tonight. Your master teacher failed whenever he came against me. So what makes you think you're even greater than your master teacher? You learning from him. So it was probably best that you backed out of this dialogue. And they got this thing going on, oh, you just gonna quote the Bible. You have blind faith. Not understanding that the things that they talk about, that's faith as well too. Why? Because you believe in history. You believe in that man's story. They want to talk about this and talk about that, making all these videos and stuff about me, but they don't want to deal with the individual person. See, Brother Kwame, I want to deal with you as an individual person. And Brother Kwame, myself, I'm not really a debater because of the madness that's going on Sidenet the TV. These people getting rich, they getting money, they getting cars and all kind of houses and stuff off of these debates. They just pimping the people. Me, I don't even want to call it a debate. I wanted to have a dialogue with you, a real dialogue. I wanted to see if I can really convert you over through the Spirit of the Most High God back to Him. That's what I wanted to do. I really came in love. When you came at me, I was happy. I was like, okay, this brother, he really wanted to probably try to learn the truth and try to turn away from the false teachings that he has been studying or looking up. So I was willing to help you, brother. But instead, you go and make a video about me disrespecting me, talking about some, oh, I'm trying to do it for fame. I'm not really a debater. Any dialogue that I have with people in the past, I didn't get paid for that. I don't get paid to sit down and have a conversation with another person about truth. I don't get paid for that. For one, I do this stuff for free. Everything what I do it for free. I don't get on the internet to try to make money from people. Now, when people donate money to me, they barely do. I do all of this stuff straight from the Most High God, Yahweh. I don't do this stuff for my own gain. we don't have to go and get no place and go and charge people $30 or $40 or $50 to come in and watch me and you have a dialogue about the truth, about what is the truth. We shouldn't have to do stuff like that. Personally, I don't believe in doing stuff like that. Now, if a person is willing to donate, that's okay, because like I told you, or like I substantiated in videos in the past, the Bible does talks about alms. And then what is the difference with people watching us in the comment boards, going back and forth editing the comment boards? I told people several times, let's either go live or we can have a conversation over the phone. It doesn't matter to me. As long as you get the truth, as long as I receive the truth, that's all it's about in these times. I sent videos and stuff to people. If you want to discuss about a certain video that I did, if you have a problem with something about that, okay, let's talk about that. Let's have a dialogue about that. But you and many other people, y'all are afraid to go live with me. Y'all are afraid to pick up that phone and have a conversation with me. But instead, y'all want to send videos out to the people. Oh, Brother Kwame this or Brother Kwame that. Brother Kwame is a false prophet. Brother Kwame is this. But you're scared. You're scared to go live with me, to have a conversation with me face to face. Listen, if that's really what you wanted to talk to me about, oh, man wrote the Bible, this and that. Man wrote every book. So what are you talking about? And as far as not seeing all of that, I see that you clearly don't want to have a dialogue with certain people that's believing in the Bible. You try to pick and choose your battles. And I think when you kept watching my videos, you started to see, oh, this brother, he's going to be a problem. Because, or your wife or whoever, because you the one that said that, she the one that said, oh, I don't think it's a good idea for you to have a dialogue with this brother. Because your wife knows, if you sit down and have a dialogue with me, I'ma end that whole parade what y'all got going on. I'ma shut all of that down. And the reason why I'ma shut it down, because y'all doing it for attention, y'all doing it for fame and to be glorified. Y'all not really doing this stuff for the truth or to really lead people to anything. Y'all trying to lead people to false teachings because y'all trying to get money off of these people. Y'all are here to be glorified because y'all don't really want to deal with me. Y'all don't want to really deal with me for real, because y'all know about me. Y'all did y'all research on me. Y'all know I'm more than a biblical scholar. I can deal with you from all aspects. I can deal with you on chronology. I can deal with you from Aaronism. You said it yourself in the email that you and your wives has been watching my videos. So you know about me. You know a little bit about me. And if you don't, you better ask about me. I've been involved in this conscious business. Book of the Dead, ID, Bible, the metal netter. You can't even speak on the metal netter. You can't speak on that. You just put the Bible down. You just love Christianity, so you can't teach on the gistic mysteries, if you know what that is. And if you don't want to deal with me, I got people for you. My brother Jerome Smith, if you want to deal with him on theology. My man Adam Coleman, he goes in hard. I got people from the Lion and Judah teach that you can deal with. But whenever you start dealing with the Book of the Dead and that Bible, you can't deal with those Egyptian mysteries. But whenever you want to talk about those mysteries, Freemasonry, Stolen Legacies, Shan Anti Diop, Ivan Vance, Jerry Mance, Romoko Nashi, been there, done that. That's what we do. We steady. We steady to show ourselves approved, just like within the biblical connotation. See, what you don't understand is Kevin Wesley, that the Most High God, he called me out of all of that mess. See, but what you want to do, you don't want to quote no Bible. You want to quote specific people since you want to play those games. That is what you want to do. You want to quote man. You are a worshiper of man. Let's do a Facebook Live on that. Don't make any other videos about me. Don't make any other post about me. If you really want to deal with scholarship, go live with the Brother Kwame. And another thing, how are you going to go forth and make a video about me, a video about Brother Kwame, and then send me an email after thousands of people viewed the video, and then you go forth and delete the video, and then send me an email explaining why you made the video? And the reason why you made the video, the true reason why you made the video, is because you wanted to cover your behind. Because you knew that Brother Kwame was coming for your behind. Brother Kwame was going to deal with you through the Spirit of the Most High God, Yahweh, and reveal the truth of what's really going on. Because like I said, you don't have good intentions of the people's hearts. You don't have good intentions of the people's thoughts. You have bad intentions to deceive these people and to trick and manipulate their minds. and to take them away from the Most High God. That is your true agenda. Because if you people think about it, what videos do y'all remember anything prior before the ex-pastor video? Somebody tell me that. This brother made that video just for it to go viral. And many people in these end times, they are turning away from the Bible. They're turning away from the gospel of Jesus Christ. That's a prophecy, another biblical prophecy that's coming to pass. So what you need to understand is you need to get right, get your mind right, get your hearts right, because the Most High God of that Bible is coming back. So what you need to understand is don't look at it from a negative connotation of, oh, I'm about to get beat up. No, don't look at it like you're going to get beat up, my brother. Look at it like you're about to get edified and your soul is about to get saved from those lakes of fire. Brother Kwame and the Lion of Judah teach, we're not here to beat you down at all. We are here to edify you and to uplift the Most High God, Yahweh. It's your boy, Brother Kwame from the Lion of Judah teach, and I'm out. Shalom.